So this is a good thing. So that's now you say go. Without reading.
Yeah, yeah. And it was dry signing by email. Normally I have to sign it with the pencil or whatever. Yeah. So that's the proof that we do it digitally now. Yeah. Well, it's a formality more or less. But sometimes you have.
Nee hoor, dat hoeft niet.
Yeah, maar well, no ik ben benieuwd of er wel mensen inloggen. Ja, so, yeah, that happens now and then. So, yeah.
Maar heb je ergens een totaal overzicht van de
noticed. Understanding, I have. I noticed, yeah. I had no clue. Understanding of what? Do you understand this form or something like that? Yeah.
Nou, ik heb vandaag wat tekeningen gemaakt. Ik heb eigenlijk gewoon de tekening van vanochtend gebruikt. En die vertaald naar het Engels. Kun je mij verstaan?
No,
helemaal goed.
I read it.
Yeah.
I didn't have the answer. Yeah.
Ik ben benieuwd.
No, I have no clue.
Heel benieuwd hoe we het gaan doen. Yeah.
I destroyed the other form, so I couldn't see whether somebody else filled it in. But now I will focus on it to see whether it's filled in.
Hoe laat gaan
we
beginnen? Nu zo'n beetje. Ja. Oké, dan ga ik maar zitten.
Wat zit te doen, Gijs, in de tussentijd?
Ik heb even een mail bijgewerkt.
Oh, wou zeggen,
het vrouw gebeld.
Ook wat geklust, of niet?
I guess. Continue? Okay. So, my name is Annika Mangold-Döring. I'm studying ecotoxicology here at Wageningen University. Good? Nice.
Ja, tegenover in de plaza.
Ja,
kantoorcomplex. Leon, hij is bang dat hij dat muziekje vanavond nog steeds hoort als hij in bed ligt. Dus hij is helemaal gehypnotiseerd erdoor.
Sorry. Oh, we zijn allemaal goed dat we...
Shop, top, shop, it over.
Yes, good afternoon and welcome from this beautiful garden, your own garden here at Wageningen University for this live broadcast. And we're going to talk for about 45 minutes, an hour, about the last weeks, how it is to work remote, how it is to be alone in the lab, and maybe the question, when can we come back? That's a big question. Uh-huh. Maybe we come to this question also. My name is Gijs, and I'll be your host today. So I'll lead you through all these conversations, and I'll tell you a little bit about how you design the perfect online meeting, because that's one of my expertise. So I can tell you how to do the online teaching and the online meetings. So I'll come to that later. But first, on my left hand, Bram de Vos, mm-hmm. Managing Director. Mm-hmm. Welcome.
Thanks.
This movie of the bicycle could be a live stream of your bike.
Yeah. So I'm quite familiar with the bicycle, and I prefer to travel and commute by bicycle too, of course. Yeah.
Till what distance do you prefer the bicycle?
Well, to work, short distance at 7 minutes. So I count the minutes there. On the racing bike, I go for 40K small ride. And with my partner, I did a 120K bike ride, but that was quite a long one.
120K. So yeah. if you have to go to the Eindhoven University, you could do it by bike.
I could do it by bike, and once in history we biked from Groningen to Wageningen. That's a serious bike ride.
The city where I live, I came from Groningen today by car. It's quite a journey, but by bike. How many hours?
It was a day job. I don't remember anymore. No.
We're not only going to talk about bicycles today. At the end of this beautiful broadcast, we have a cartoon. I go to you. You make cartoons for a living. That's what you do.
Yes,
Suus.
That's right.
What is a good cartoon?
A good cartoon. Well, I hope I will make some pictures today that I listen carefully, and then I can make some little jokes about what you're talking about.
You make jokes. I see one here. Maybe the audience is there. You can show it. This is about working at home. Maybe.
It's difficult
somebody
to
has cats.
I know I have to. Yeah, put it over there. Yeah.
Cats, dogs, young children.
Yeah, we don't know what happens at home when you're working from us.
And how easily can you change this if I would like to have a longer tail or some extra ears?
Oh, no possible? Problem. It's just a matter of seconds. Let's see. I can erase the tail. And then I can make it as long as you like.
Look.
So, like this, brilliant. I can paint the dog over here. You prefer dogs, I heard.
I prefer dogs, it's a little bit like Bob Ross, the early days.
Yeah.
Okay. I'll come back to you some other time during this broadcast, and then we have some pictures. And at the end, there's the grand finale, and then you show all of it.
Like Thanks. A visual wrap-up.
Good luck.
Thank you very much. Have fun.
Bram, we'll talk about four things. Mm-hmm. How you stay connected, working remote. Mm-hmm. How it is to get out of your comfort zone, because I think we have to go out of our comfort zone in several mm-hmm. ways mm-hmm. in this new situation. Work goes on, so we're going to talk with Annika, one mm-hmm. of the last researchers in the lab, mm-hmm. and opportunities. So that's at the end.
Yeah.
But first of all, how was it for you the last six, 7 weeks?
Yeah, well, let's start when it all started. And I was in Indonesia with the trade delegation and we had to come back and the whole corona thing started to become really serious, I think, stopping handshaking, difficulties getting back and coming back here. It was direct meetings every day and discussing things, how to organize things, where is everybody, a lot of people and students and employees abroad, how to get them back. So yeah. That was the first instance.
Was that the biggest challenge?
That was a big challenge, also get the overview. And it was nice, we made a geographical information system. We knew where everybody was and the location, and then we picked it up and then we saw, well, how can we solve the situation? So a lot of effort. But then the big issue started with education, of course, and all the lecturers trying to get the courses online. And a lot of effort was put into that. And mm-hmm. we had to facilitate that and see how it works. And then later on, we got all the issues with the buildings, of course, and how to organize mm-hmm. that. Yeah.
And going to the education, Brightspace, I think, is the environment, the online teaching.
Yeah. And luckily, that was introduced, I think, a year ago or so. So we were accommodated to that already. And mm-hmm. that appeared to be quite a success and helpful, as I understood, because I'm not a user myself. So, but still, all courses had to be online now. And that was a huge effort because people were not prepared and they worked night and day to get it done. And it was quite successful in Wageningen.
It is quite successful now. Yeah. I can imagine it's quite stressful for both teaching and studying online.
Yeah.
Is it?
It is, yeah. And the workload, I think, for lecturers was pretty high, I think. So everybody worked pretty hard, but also for the students now to study from home. For some, it's quite good and they like it. It's more efficient. For others, it's really a struggle to be focused and being isolated in the little room and then following those courses online and also doing the exams online, so which is new too.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I have a lot of questions, but if you have some questions, you can go to the chat and please be so kind to ask questions and I'll bring them into the conversation. That's no problem. I'm going to check the chat now for the first time. No questions so far, but if you have, feel free to join us. That's why we are here, remote but close. You talk about teaching online. One of the things I can say from my experience is that it's very hard to communicate with a screen. Mm-hmm. You see this in theater also. Mm-hmm. You go to theater sometimes?
To the theater. Yes.
Have you ever been to stand-up comedy or cabaret?
Yeah.
Do you know why the first row is always empty?
I'm normally not sitting on the first row.
Nobody's sitting on the first row. Because they think maybe the comedian comes to me, is going to ask me something. So there's high adrenaline and high awareness by the audience. The thing is with online meetings is that we know there's a screen between us. So we're a little bit passive. Mm-hmm. We have to work very hard to be to pay attention to things. And that's just, it takes a lot from our battery. Mm-hmm. So that's one thing to keep in mind if you teach online or you want to have meetings online. Mm-hmm. Try to break through the wall. So talk to the camera, ask people to go into the chat. Mm-hmm. And it will work a little bit more easy.
Okay.
Yeah. What is the best lesson for you so far in this new period?
That we adapt pretty fast, that we were able to do that with a big organization like this, how to organize that, and that is a lot of energy and initiative bottom up, I think, to organize it yourself, because you can help and facilitate, but it's finally up to the people to do that, and that was pretty successful, I think. So we're able to adapt to new situations rather fast.
And for you personal, is there a difference in work at home, a balance or things?
Yeah, I don't like to work from home that much, so I prefer to go to my office. So in the beginning I had to sign a lot of papers still, so I felt that I was allowed to go to the office. It was a good reason, but now we organize that all I can do it by email, so I don't have a good reason anymore, so that means I stay at home. But it's more difficult for me to start up and not to being distracted, especially when I see the garden and the sun is shining. Yeah.
And maybe some music instruments around you.
Yeah, yeah, that doesn't help too. And I think, I see a guitar standing there, but I don't touch it then. But that's not very helpful. And if I'm in my office, I'm really focused. I know what I'm supposed to do. I like that. That's fine. That's better for me. Yeah.
I thought before this whole situation came up that this was some kind of master thesis problem for myself. I can imagine when I was graduating from a master thesis that I had to do everything but not studying. Mm-hmm. But it comes back these days.
Yeah,
I think
a
lot of people can experience the same.
Yeah.
Something else. There are a few colleagues of you who made movies, and I really would like to go to the first movie about staying connected, Melle Nicholas.
On the 20th of May, I defended my thesis entitled Farmers as Water Managers. I was really looking forward to that day and organized a big gathering at the Hoylande with live music and with a big bonfire. It turned out to be a bit different. The online defense itself was still very intense. The only difference was that I sometimes did not see the opponents. That is just whether they have turned on their camera or not. Easy to solve. I have a couple of tips for anyone that has to defend themselves or is or wants to contribute to the festivities after the defense. The first one is make sure that you're not alone in that day. Two is ask colleagues, friends, family for contributions to share in an online environment after. I really enjoyed the little bit awkward song of my WRM colleagues. It was one of the highlights. Three, signing the thesis is a great moment to pop some champagne. And I think that is still possible to do outside. So I think that defenses should not turn back to normal. Having someone fly in as an opponent or as a co-promoter should not be the standard anymore. I think that online defenses and ceremonies offer opportunities that should be further explored. For me personally, an online defense and an online gathering after turned out to be one of the best days in my life so far. And that is despite of or due to it being partly online. Who knows?
What do you think, what Mel is saying? You agree on it?
Yeah, it was quite positive. So yeah. I'm pretty amazed that it was successful and that he's positive about it. And it gives him opportunities too.
Yeah, if flying is not the standard, it gives opportunities for other countries maybe.
Yeah. So, and hybrid models, I think some people in and some others online, that could be possible too. So I see a lot of opportunities in general, I think, for more online activities.
Yes, and are there some opportunities specific you're working on these days to work it out?
We did it already before because we are participating in a climate conference, and especially in a climate conference you don't want people to fly in, and I think can we do something online even with students from all over the world, and that would make it also more accessible for all countries. People don't have the money to fly but they can participate, so that's really an opportunity.
There is a question, Bram. How do you stay in contact if you only talk about work online? So if you have a meeting, what would you recommend? I can say something, but I would like
to do it first. So in our meetings, it's standard to go around the table first and to warm up a little bit, to start about something positive in your life or something negative or whatever you want to bring to the table, or how was your weekend, and start with that. That breaks the ice a little bit, and not only the serious stuff, and that follows later. It's it's a bit up to the group, but up to the chair how to organize a meeting.
And you see it in all layers of the organization that if they meet up online, they just start with some small talk.
It's not happening everywhere. It depends. You have those very formal meetings that externals say you don't do that, but internally we see it happening often. Yeah,
I would say that if you design a meeting online, you shouldn't do it longer than 60 minutes. Do you agree on that?
I agree on that personally. Sometimes it's organized for you and it will take longer, but then you feel, well, it drains the energy. At least you need to have a break or some activities in between, and that's hard because often it goes on and on.
Yeah. I think if you design 60 minutes or something, you have to be aware of the fact that you have to do different things in these 60 minutes. So maybe you start off with some small talk, then you do a 10-minute about a research, then you do some small talk, just make a rhythm, make dynamics in it. Because it's very easy if you look to the screen and maybe some people looking out to me that you go into this dialogue of the monologue instead of a dialogue.
Yeah.
And then people fall asleep and they think about the garden and playing guitar.
Yeah. That's not good, eh?
No. I would like to go to the second point of today, and that's out of our comfort zone. Out of the comfort zone, is that something you experienced these months?
Yeah, now and then, because, well, not going to work, starting up, I think, and being focused, so that, well, asks for some discipline.
Yeah.
So, and it's easier to be here and to start, so it's not really out of my comfort zone, so it was not that difficult, but also starting activities, contact people outside the organization yourself, and by meetings, but yeah, it's getting normal, so, but it's getting used to it, yeah.
Bram, we experienced this in the first webinar also. There's some delay on the chat, but I really would like to ask you this question. It's about staying connected.
Okay.
Only PC defense goes by compared to a live event. Ah, a great point of online defense. We can use to beam robots or to bring in the expert in a hologram. Is it something you would like to see?
I see a connection. We're talking and we're developing a visualization lab. So yes. A hologram would be an element of it, I think. I don't know if you can combine it with PhD defenses, but new types of visualization, we're thinking about that.
Then you can do five of these broadcasts at one time.
Oh, okay. That's very efficient.
Very efficient. The comfort zone, if you compare it to your colleagues all over the world, is there some difference in adapting this new situation?
Internationally, I think there are different stages, because I think here at where we were relatively flexible, but still allowing people to go to laboratories and making exceptions. So it was not that it was a total close down. It was an intelligent lockdown, and we were a little bit flexible there too, and we still are. In other countries, it was a total lockdown, so that was even it was more difficult for them. So yeah, there are differences, I think, but yeah, not specific for the research side, I think, but in general, how countries.
Did you manage to keep in touch with all the stakeholders and all your colleagues over the world?
Yeah. For me, it was mainly the other research institutes. For example, we have a big international environmental network, so that continued, but it was harder to do it online. We had breaks, we had discussions, so yeah, that worked well. Yeah.
A lot of people, I think, or people watching also, would like to know what's going to be the next step. Can we go back to the lab? Can we go back to school? Can you tell something about the future?
Yeah. So first of all, of course, we don't have to go back. We are here already. There's a lab work always continued, always with social distancing. Well, the first rule remains, you have to work from home if possible. That will be the main rule, but we will become a little bit more flexible. So we have the crucial group who can work in the office. So that's the priority.
And when
group.
Is some when is it crucial?
Crucial if you do define? If you redo lab work, PhD lab work, or you have to do field work, or you have to work on safety issues within the building. You have crucials, legal affairs have to be in to sign stuff and to organize stuff. So those roles, we will define them, and then we have other groups, and we will allow a little bit more from the 15th onwards. I think where there can be exceptions that will go through the manager. You can ask the management allow the entrance to the buildings. So we will look at that. And you can see the buildings are changed already. There are arrows everywhere. It's one-way streets everywhere in the building. So we defined the maximum corona capacity. And we're going to fill that stepwise and improvise. So I can't give a long-term perspective because there's still a lot of uncertainty, but we are building up. And that will start the 15th of June.
Yeah, so we start coming back. We've never been away. But
never
I
been away.
Think,
yeah. No.
Mohammed Hatim had a very a good one, I think. We should say mixing online and physical defense would be a better solution. So combine the best of two worlds.
I think we
all agree on that.
Often hybrid models work best.
Thank you, Mohammed.
It's always a bit of a compromise.
It's a compromise. Yeah. We have another movie from one of your colleagues. We're going to Chantal Hendricks.
My name is Chantal Hendricks and I'm working for the Sustainable Soil Use Group of Wageningen Environmental Research. I'm working on different projects that involve carbon and nutrient modeling in agricultural systems. These projects involve many stakeholders. And to stay in contact with these stakeholders, we already had much contact by phone, so that did not change much over the last couple of weeks. But what did change is contact with colleagues. Normally, you walk into each other's office to ask a question or to discuss an issue. But because this was not possible anymore, and you had to set up a meeting with them as well, that just feels a bit less efficient. I'm therefore also very happy that despite everything, we managed to set up a pot experiment as part of the Nutri2Cycle project. This project aims to close the carbon, nitrogen, and phosphorus loops by increasing the efficiency on and between cropping systems, livestock systems, and the industry that processes agro residues. In the pot experiment, we are analyzing how well bio-based fertilizers perform compared to chemical fertilizers by estimating a so-called fertilizer replacement value. In parallel, we are also testing the effect of these fertilizers on potato yields on a farm to see whether we can bring science into practice and scale up the use of bio-based fertilizers as a replacement for chemical fertilizers.
I have to say I was really happy when we could start this experiment because we were sitting behind a computer already for a few weeks.
Working from home is for me not really out of my comfort zone, but finding different ways to become productive again and to stay in contact with people asks for creativity and adaptability. But I would like to give you two examples of when I had to come out of my comfort zone. And the first one is by making this movie. And the second one I would like to show you a non-work related example of when I had to come out of my comfort zone.
I really enjoy swimming, but because the swimming pools were closed, I discovered this nice open water to swim in. Sometimes you need to dive into the deep to discover something new.
Discover something new. Did you swim in these kinds of meertjes of oceans?
No, that's not my cup of tea. I leave that to Chantal. The temperature has to be 25 centigrade for me.
But she's saying, as I think she makes a very good point on the comfort zone, that it's not easy to go on camera or to see yourself.
Mm-hmm.
I think that's a problem if people meet remote.
Mm-hmm.
You see yourself, you're completely distracted. Mm-hmm. And your brain is completely distracted because it wants to read all the faces of the people you see.
Mm-hmm.
So sometimes it's good to just turn off the camera and make it more like a phone call. And then put it on after a while, because it can you can go in very low energy after seeing 10 faces in 5 minutes.
Mm-hmm.
Did you experience things like that?
I experienced that, and if you switch off your camera, you can jump up and you don't have to sit on your chair anymore.
Yeah, you can move.
You can
for
move.
Your creativity, about creativity, you have to move.
So I do that now and then.
Is there, she said, it needs creativity to get yourself in a new work mode and to get in this new situation. What's your personal lesson? You're very easily distracted at home. What was the lesson? How did you manage to work?
Try to keep my schedule. I start early, not that late. So I have just meetings. Mm-hmm. Sometimes I have a meeting at 8 o'clock. I don't like that. 9 o'clock. That's fine to start at, but keep the rhythm. So. And here the buildings close nowadays at 6 o'clock, so that's a good time to stop, I think. Yeah.
Then you go on bike back home.
If I'm in the building, but nowadays I go on the bike for a racing round. So that's the goal now.
In a bit we're going to talk with Annika, so I would like to get her prepared to go on the table.
Mm-hmm.
And in the meanwhile, I go to the cartoons.
Hi.
Can you give us two maybe?
Yes,
we're very.
Right.
This is my impression of a first time giving an online lecture. I think it's terribly
scary. Scary, terrifying. Yes.
So
yeah.
This is
nice.
Thank you. And this is my idea of online defense.
Online nice. Defense party. Yeah.
Best party of my life.
I think this is the party Melle would like to see.
I think
but
so,
Mohammed
yeah.
always this Mohammed is walking into people who are live there. So that's the best of both worlds.
Yeah.
Maybe for the next round you can make somebody standing here so then we feel the new world. Yeah.
Cool. I will.
Thanks. I'll come back to you in a bit for the grande finale, but first one of the last people working here in the lab, Annika. Welcome, Annika.
Hi.
Welcome to the table. We talked Dutch before, but now we're going to do it in English.
Sorry, it's
so you're one of these not famous persons because nobody sees you, but you were one of the last working here. Is it true?
Yeah, that's just circumstances.
Just circumstances.
Because, we wanted to start just before Corona happened, let's say. So we were already ready to go, and then we decided, since we were seeing it's getting more restricted and everything, we decided to stop. And once it was possible again, we could pick it up where we left it, basically.
So start by start, what exactly are you researching?
So my PhD is about the effects of chemicals and climate change on freshwater ecosystems, particularly insects. So right now we're doing some toxicity tests with pesticides and how the insects are affected by it.
So that's not something you can do at home?
No, I don't think I want to work with the chemicals at home for once. We need a big water facility, so like a water bath, we call it, to have the right temperature for the individuals and to control the setting in a way that I don't think I can do it in my bedroom.
What are the benefits of having this this space and the relaxedness around you? Are there some benefits I can imagine?
Well, the most obvious benefit is that you might not have to think so much about is anyone else using this facility right now? Is anyone else needed this pH meter or something? So you can just like take it, but that's the beginning. So like it was really just me and my colleague Anna that were working here, and
it's
now
only
it's
you and Anna. So
well, it was yeah. So but now I'm also happy that other people start again in the lab. And now there's another challenge that we have to make sure that we share things now, and we really also have to share the space in a very different way than we have before. You mentioned the restrictions on the maximum people in one room, for example. So that's something that you didn't have to think before, but now you do. Yeah.
And now I can imagine if people are coming a little bit more back to the lab, it's a challenge to combine all the research in this new situation.
Mm-hmm.
Is planning the key there?
Planning is the key, but also self-awareness, I think, because you can plan whatever you do, but it's about the people and to behave and give each other feedback in a constructive way, so that's helpful. And keep that social distancing, even in the labs or in the rooms. And the big issue is ventilation, of course, and the corridors, so stuff like that. But I think it's pretty well organized, but we'll have to see how it works.
Your planning skills are way better now than they were, you told me before, is it true?
Yeah. So I used to be already a good planner for long term, but now that is of course not always possible. So what I can do is like supporting people with at least trying to plan a little bit long term. But I also learn from other people to do like to be a bit more adaptive and to also have small like very short-term planning and very like just living in the moment in that time also needs to be done right now.
I can imagine that it's for some inspiration and creativity it's good to meet some other people at the coffee machine maybe. How did you experience not the toevallige rendezvous? How did you
So I think there's only one coffee machine right now that's working.
That's working.
That's what I know from my colleagues. Yeah, but I'm not a big coffee drinker, so I don't see them. But yeah, I see a lot of people working here in the building to make it nice again. So there was also like painting the stairs and redoing the stairs and this kind of stuff. So that's the people that you see. And then the technicians that are still supporting us in the lab.
We have some questions. Let me read. Somebody tells, and this is a very good one. In my experience, this is about closing the webcam. There's some delay on the chat. Mm-hmm. In my experience, it's the opposite. It's much harder to meet with people without webcams because a lot of the body language is lost. That's true, but it's about to make the combination. If you put it on for an hour, it's very intensive. And if you put it off for an hour, I can imagine it's very hard because you think, who's there? I'm not talking to somebody. But you have to graduate it a little bit. But sometimes just put off the cam and put it on. Another thing is that if you want to have some creativity in your meeting, then it can be very useful to say, okay, now go for a walk for 10 minutes, but come back to the laptop in 10 minutes and just make an alarm or something that people can wander in their rooms. That's what you said.
Mm-hmm.
If you want the creativity, you have to move. Just only sitting with laptop on, cam on and talking is not good for your brain and for your creativity. So just try to variate on what you do online. That's the point, but not always off. That's the true one.
Mm.
Where is that? It looks like very clean water. I think this is about your water research.
No, I think that's about the video of the woman that were
I
swimming,
think that
right?
Is, yeah. we're going to find it out, maybe to the redactie. Waar is dat zwembaden?
Van Chantal.
We'll come back to that one and then we can swim. Oh, there it is. That's in Vught, near Den Bosch. Ah. It's called the Iron Man. So people, if you want to go there, but not now because we're here in live broadcast. If everything is going to be normal, whatever normal is, what's the biggest lesson and the best lesson from this situation for you as a person?
Yeah, I think it's important that we agree that we are still human and we are all somewhat on the same boat. So we support each other the best we can. And for me, it was very nice that I was working with a colleague. So if that's at all possible to like team up and not be alone on yourself, that already helped me quite a lot. So I think.
Yeah.
Maybe
I can imagine that a lot of students from abroad feel a little bit lost these days.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe this is the place where you meet your friends and your colleagues. Any tips and tricks on how do you get keep close to each other?
Yeah, I think it's important to really, yeah, go out of your comfort zone. So to really be the one engaging, so be active in that sense to really ask for help when you need it, and even if it's just a chat, like even if you just need an ear from a colleague for a moment, so then just ask for it, because I'm pretty sure people are willing to help, and they might even feel the same, so then then it's a win-win anyways.
Yeah.
So
it's a win-win for an ear, and maybe some game nights you talked before about.
Yeah, so yeah, I made some good experience with organizing just like very shortly game nights, like a Pictionary kind of thing. So you meet in a Zoom meeting or a Skype or whatever there is, and play around and then draw some pictures and have fun with each other and getting to know each other better also. Even have a beer in the evening together online.
Have a remote
that's also
beer
nice.
With all the all
remote
the people.
Beer. Yeah, but you could go for a walk together with two people or so to have that connection here outside Wageningen. It's in the forest, it's easy to do. So
actually we also set up a running app together in our group. So we can see when people go for a run, and that's also a bit, if you're like I am a bit of a competitive person, so if I can see, oh, someone is running more than I am, then I am motivated to run as well. So that can also be something. So there's several ways.
The running app, what is called on cam? So people want to run.
Well, I'm not sponsored by anything, but the one that we're using is the Adidas running app. And it's funny because our supervisor is there also, And I made sure last month I was I beat him, so I made a screenshot making sure that was documented.
People react to your walking so and running an app.
Let's see if he's on the call.
I think he was on the first one. Yeah. But maybe
people say, luckily, I have a dog, so I think running and walking is very easily. And walk in the park during bilateral calls will help. Zumba works great in the living room. Okay, Zumba in the living room.
Mm-hmm.
If you're not distracted enough, you can start a Zumba course.
That's a good idea. Yes.
Great. Thanks for these great tips. You stay on the table a bit if you want to. Then we can go to the last part of this broadcast opportunities.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, opportunities. That's a big one. Yes, always, everywhere.
Always, yeah. And a manager is always seeing opportunities.
Always seeing opportunities.
Management
never
talk.
Waste a good crisis. All these cliches on the table.
Yeah.
But to go to this point, where do you see real opportunities?
Well, in general, and not only related to the Corona crisis. I think we have also a nitrogen big issue in the Netherlands. Yesterday it was broadcasted, of course, the Commission Remkes gave advice, and we see a lot of opportunities there to help to find solutions to connect agriculture with nature, with biodiversity. How can you make the best of the two? We came up with proposals for the future for the Netherlands already 100 years from now. It's a direction and we want to continue that discussion. So we are really setting the agenda there. So we see opportunities and we can combine that. That's at the national level. We can scale it up to a European level. We have the European Green Deal, and that's in the middle of the expertise of ESG. So there are opportunities.
Mm-hmm.
And then we have Corona itself, of course, and we can do some research on that. So we have a whole portfolio of Wageningen University and research work on Corona.
Mm-hmm.
That's from vaccines till even the animal-human interactions, mm-hmm. and everything in between. So there are opportunities, but we have to be realistic. There are big uncertainties too. Mm-hmm. Financial, what will happen with the government, with the funding, stuff like that. Mm-hmm. International collaboration, will the students be here or not? So we have to face that. Look at the opportunities, we're also able to adapt again.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
And I can imagine that in a normal situation, if you see opportunities or you see the world changing, that you go to your stakeholders,
mm-hmm.
and you talk a little bit, you do the agenda setting together.
Uh-huh. Yeah.
Now you don't have these rendezvous. How do you do it?
We still do it online, of course. So we are in touch European head on the European agenda. So mm-hmm. that's helpful. But also with the ministries in our domain, I think government is pretty important. But also with the stakeholders. Which we are doing projects, of course.
Yeah.
So keep in touch with them. That's the advice.
Yeah.
Don't hold back. Don't think we have to wait till the situation is normal again, because that can take a while. Just contact them.
Yeah.
Yeah.
What's the first thing that pops in mind when I say opportunities for you?
I think, actually, the first thing is basically that we know that we have to build up to the normal life again, so that's a fact. So mm-hmm. then, yeah, we just have the opportunity to change things while we are doing it anyways. You mm-hmm. know what I mean? Like, if you have to clean out your closet anyways, then you can do it in the most efficient way.
This is a good momentum.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So then there's this initiative from the EU also to, like, say, build back better,
mm-hmm.
or, and then also greener maybe, and this kind of stuff. So that's what pops in my mind, because that's, I think, on social media also, that people see it as a chance
mm-hmm.
to change maybe even problems that were there other than Corona.
Okay, cool. So. The last movie clip of today from one of your colleagues, Sharon Zondervan.
Good afternoon, colleagues. This is Sharon Zondervan calling in from my spare bedroom, now my office, as most of you will probably work at home from now. In this short video, specifically for this online event, I would like to share some of my observations working at home, but also strolling around in my environment around the house here, leading, who knows, perhaps to new research questions. New opportunities for us for the coming period as a result of this current crisis. How can we, as researchers, help public and private owners of these busy terrains to manage the crowds? Do we have digital tools available? to identify where risk areas might be? Or can we communicate with people that want to visit nature areas at a specific moment? At the same time, this should also be a great opportunity for you because this is basically a unique, let's hope so at least, period in time that would allow baseline management measurements that would be impossible to do in other times. What's the effect of airplanes on cloud formation? And is there a subsequent effect of cloud formation on weather and weather prediction? Another question is what is the effect of human presence on wild animal behavior? My plea to you is do not wait for proposals to be granted or to write them in the first place. Get started now because this is really an unprecedented time. On the one hand, let's hope that this will never occur again. But on the other hand, this is a unique situation. So I would say go for the opportunities that we have right now.
Bram, there was a question on the chat and then we come back to the, mm-hmm. to the movie clip about my workspace, mm-hmm. the plan. How do you see it when things go back to the normal?
Yeah. To be honest, the my workspace was a planning and concept of a safe and good workplace. Mm-hmm. But in we had a lot of pressure on the workspace. But I think, the situation will change now because working from home is becoming partially normal again. So the easy answer is, of course, a hybrid model will probably be the future. Mm-hmm. And I think the plans will be re-evaluated because now, as long as Corona still is here, I think we have to look at ventilation. You see now the bigger rooms is only for one person. So, and there was a totally different concept that there was more movement. And I think there will be a re-evaluation of that. Yeah. So it's not putting on hold, but it's postponed a little bit. So, mm-hmm. but I think with all the new information, my expectation is that will be re-evaluated and will be replanned.
Yeah. For people who want to have heads up on what are you doing, what are you planning, and when are you tighten up the it a little bit, where can we go to have some insights?
Well, people like to have perspective, of course. When are we able to go to work again? So again, I think we have that maximum Corona capacity. That's the starting point. We starting with the crucial roles. They will get admission. They can start work, and that's business as usual. To be honest, I think, and it's more about the second group, and that mm-hmm. will go through the management. So we have a special team looking at that, and it should be proportional and it should be fair across the organization. And then we're looking if we have difficult cases, people having real mental issues or really having issues at home, they will get the priority. But it will be exceptions. It will have to be go through the executive board or to ourselves. But we want to be as flexible as possible and to fill up that capacity and then learn and adapt to the situation.
A question from Floor Huisman. Thanks, Floor. Very interesting. You can think about it a little bit. To what extent will it be possible to make a positive green impact in the post-corona period when the recovering economy may take priority over the climate and environmental issues?
Mm-hmm.
That's a good one.
Yeah, that's a good one. That's a quite political one, of course, and then you can have your personal opinions. That's maybe not that relevant, but if we can make it a
win, it is relevant, but
if we can make it a win-win, and you see it now as you hold the discussion on nitrogen, they say no, not less nature reserves, no more is the advice. So that was interesting. The flying, should we invest really in Schiphol? Can we not limit it? The traffic, shouldn't we invest in trains and good connections that are served? The amount of agriculture in the Netherlands, how to adapt to climate change. I think there's an opportunity, but there's a risk too. If we want to go back to normal and put all the effort into that and business as usual, then maybe you lose an opportunity.
Mm-hmm. How do you see that? Maybe on a personal title?
Yeah, it's of course personal. I'm not a politician. But I think what I realized for myself is what I actually don't need.
Mm-hmm.
So I also realized that like all the extra things, going out for dinner, I mean, there's a social compartment to that as well, but going out for dinner that often, now I cook more for myself.
Okay.
But then, of course, that is affecting the economy for this as well. But then you can also take away food. I don't know, I think we experienced so many things that we took for granted, and there's things that we want to keep up, like the food.
Well, yeah, but some things,
but some things that are
really
not that
necessary.
Important. Yeah.
So do you feel the same? Did you maybe forever change the way you live now?
Well, that's changed already through my kids, so they're behaving differently, less meat already, so yeah, that's helpful, of course. So, and travel will be different, I think. Those travels far away, I think people will behave differently, or it will be socially maybe less accepted in your surroundings. So it's opportunities for our tourism department that will be more national. We discover the Netherlands or more local tourism or holidays more, I think. So that are opportunities, and that will be the normal, and that's okay too. So there are opportunities there.
Some compliments for both of you. Really nice to see and hear the experiences and adaptiveness of colleagues. So thanks for you. Before I go to the last question, and maybe for the last thing you would like to say, and then I go to Suus. If you are into some online meetings these next months, keep in mind, don't do it longer than 60 minutes, break it up in parts, make it interactive so that people are attached to you and it's interactive. Otherwise, it's just one monologue, people fall asleep, it takes a lot of energy, and because we miss all these non-verbal cues, it's very high intensive to follow it. So keep it short, make contact and talk about how you feel, and maybe sometimes talk about the dog, talk about music, talk about other things than work, and then you will have perfect online meetings. Is there anything I've missed on the table? Any question, anything you want to add?
No, I think we are in challenging times, but we're doing well. So I'm quite proud of the organization, of the whole of Wageningen, but also of the Environmental Sciences Group, how we handled the situation. My worry is still, I think, the vitality of the workforce, of course, the employees, especially at the university side, the lecturers, the teachers, a lot of work. So hopefully we can relax a little bit there, and taking holidays too. Take your holidays.
Yes.
Even if you stay in the Netherlands or stay local at home, but do that, because that's really necessary, I think. Take your free time.
Yeah.
And I think we were more adaptive than I thought. So that was good. So proud
very
of
good.
That. Yeah.
Yes. Thanks. And thank you for having for being on the table at my side. I go to Suus. You don't want to miss this. Suus.
Hi. I will show you what I made.
Cool.
This one you know already. Am I already on the screen?
Yeah, there's the screen. Yes, what do? Yeah.
This is like working from home. This was a big challenge for teachers to give online lessons. My sister is a teacher as well, and she was really, really, really nervous. For
I can see.
But she adapted. So this was online lessons, and I made a hybrid version.
Yes,
for you.
Cool. Thank you. Yeah, for Mohammed, who was talking about the hybrid, so that's very good.
I think the girl is happy that she's on the physical part of the
department. It's not the first bottle if I see it. No, yeah, okay.
Well, this is the warming up before the meeting starts. So maybe it's a good idea to have a timer, something like that, because people like to talk about their own stories. Well, working from home whenever possible. Well, this lady, she made her own
this
homelet.
This is Annika, if she's not, if she couldn't go to this
exactly.
place. Yes.
And this is how people look like if they have had too much Zoom sessions on one day.
Yeah.
And this is Annika. This is you, Annika, in alone in the lab. The echo. And I can imagine this can be a bit lonely to be there all by yourself. Well, running together is a good solution, especially if you have a running mate who is not so good in running. Keeps a distance 1.5 meter. Well, this is a momentum for change, so grab this moment. And this is my last picture, and I think I made a spelling failure.
Oh, no
but,
problem.
I didn't have time to erase and correct myself. So, well, this is adapting to the new situation.
Thank you so much, Suus.
You're welcome.
For everybody, if you want to see, here I am, if you want to see the paintings of Suus, we'll give them to you, and an outline of what we have set on the table also. So tips and tricks, they'll come to you. Thank you for watching us, and we really would like to see you again on another occasion on a live broadcast. Have a good weekend, have a good week, have a good holiday, have a good summer.
Thank you.
Show me the light.